Hello everyone, welcome back to Auto Trend TV. I am Viprajesh again from Ambal Nexa Coimbatore. I am here with the new Maruti Suzuki XL6. The XL6 is essentially a crossover version of the Maruti Suzuki Ertiga, but it is still an MPV with some additional body claddings and a much more beefier appeal to it. As you can see, this new XL6 has got a much more beefier front with a bigger grille, better headlamp setup and a fog cladding all around the car. These headlamps are all LED units. They call it the quad LED because there are four chambers of LED lights in this headlamp setup, and that looks really cool, and it also lights up really cool at night. The fog lamps are also LED and they really help the appeal of this car. The bonnet of this car is much more squared off and has that muscular lines and appeal when compared to the Ertiga. The fog cladding and fog skid plate are all around the car, which give it a much more rugged appeal. The bonnet, as you can see, it's much more beefed up. It is also heavier and larger than on the Ertiga, which really helps the appeal of this new cross MPV. On the sides, you can see that the frontal section has got a much more squared off finish than on the Ertiga. It has got this faux plastic finish, vent kind of look to it on the sides. On the side, you can easily notice the Ertiga resemblance on the XL6. Largely, everything remains the same on the side as the Ertiga except for the frontal bonnet section. It is easy to notice the Ertiga. Only the thing is that this car additionally gets much more black cladding and a massive roof rail setup. So it looks okay, but the thing is the fog cladding on the wheel arches are really big and deep and really don't suit the wheel size of this MPV. The wheel size remains exactly the same as on the Ertiga. They are just R15 wheels with 185 section tires. So that really does not help the rugged appeal and such massive wheel arches and the wheel arch claddings on this vehicle. Although this does help the appeal of this car, you can see that this vehicle has got a front disc and rear drum brake setup. So yeah, it has even got the exactly similar chrome door handles on the sides as on the Maruti Suzuki Ertiga. The ORVMs though are all black and have got a glossy black finish on them, which is really in contrast with the body color. The roof rails are massive. They are the longest roof rails I have ever seen on any production vehicle, and they really make the Ertiga look much more taller. I mean, make this XL6 much more taller. Coming to the rear section of the new Maruti Suzuki XL6, you can see that it largely remains exactly similar to the Ertiga, except for the fact that on the Ertiga, you would have noticed that only the inside part of the tail light actually lights up when you switch on the headlamps. But on this XL6, you can see that the whole edge of the tail lamp is full LED and lights up really nice. Apart from that, you can see that the bumper design is sharper and more aggressive with the massive black cladding and the fog skid plate finish. It kind of gives it a tough stance, and the spare tire of course is underneath the car just like on the Ertiga. And apart from that, we have the reverse camera underneath the chrome lining, so just above the number plate. Well, the next differentiation being the center part of this boot lid has got a glossy black finish on the XL6 as compared to the body colored boot lid of the Ertiga. Then we have the exact same defogger for the rear windshield along with wipe wash function. It is exactly the same size and shape as on the Ertiga. Well, there is nothing to differentiate except for these small changes. Even the smart hybrid badging is exactly the same at the exact same place. Well, it is a fine looking car. It just looks, in concept, it looks similar to the Honda BRV, which on the other hand was a tougher design and SUV-ish Honda Mobilio. This one is an SUV-ish Maruti Ertiga.
Well, it looks fine at the front, but at the rear, it looks exactly like the Ertiga, not much to differentiate, but it is still looking good, except for the fact that the wheels are a bit very small.
Right now, I am inside the new XL6. Well, first of all, everything on the inside is reminiscent of the new Ertiga. Each panel, each design element, and each material is exactly the same as on the Ertiga. Only thing is that this is an all-black interior instead of the beige and grey combination on the Maruti Ertiga. Of course, this being an automatic transmission, there are certain small differences when you compare with the comparative manual transmissions. So, yeah, this is the first look at the interior of the new Maruti XL6. Well, it is no longer new. It is just exactly same as the Maruti Ertiga, except for certain new things. This XL6 comes with cruise control feature as standard from the Zeta variant itself. Basically, there are only two variants, the Zeta and Alpha, and both the variants get cruise control feature on the steering wheel. The steering wheel itself remains same, except for the black color, which is kind of a premium and sporty feel, I guess. But they have tried to mimic the new Tata Hexa updated model in terms of the captain seats and all. So it is basically an all black cabin, all black seats, and everything is all black. So it works to a certain extent, but the thing is, the quality has not been improved by any margin. It's still all scratchy plastics and really hollow feeling materials all the way, even on the door pads. And even the door pad cushioning is not actually a cushion, it's actually a softened plastic panel. So it feels soft to touch, but it is not soft. It is a kind of a hardish, well, kind of softish material. List of all the controls remain exactly the same, which is not really good for such a premium branded car. All the controls remain exactly the same from the Swift, basically the 2005 Swift. I think they have been carrying those controls from the 2005 Swift into the CRs, the S-Cross, and almost every car. So that's what I again don't like in this interior. These buttons also are the same in quality, but they look just a bit better than on my Ertiga, on the 2012 Ertiga. Basically, this here is the push button start. So the push button start feature is also standard on both variants, so that's also a really good thing. Over here you can see that this is the alarm off for the perimeter security, and this here is the traction control. So this being an automatic transmission vehicle, only the automatic variants get the electronic stability program and traction control feature as standard. Both the variants, the Zeta and Alpha, get automatic transmission options. This basically is a four-speed torque converter unit from the Ertiga, and I guess the CRs also. You can see that it's as simple as any other automatic transmission to use. There is a parking mode, there is a reverse mode, this is the neutral, the drive mode, and you can even hold on the gear to the second in case you are climbing some hills or something, some emergency purpose. And this is the low gear mode. So I think that the low gear mode basically holds on the gear to first gear. I am not sure exactly, but it's okay. The next thing you can see that even the center console is carried over from the Maruti Ertiga. You can see that these cooled cup holders are also carried from the Ertiga. Even, well, exactly the same. It's exactly the same except for this armrest. This is a sliding armrest, which works fine. It's okay, but the storage inside is definitely not good. It's just very small. You can store only your phone or something inside, so it's definitely not big. The cabin also is not as wide to accommodate a much larger armrest also. It is a standard handbrake over here. There are no other storage spaces around it. I think this space has been wasted to a certain extent. But that is all, and this here is the key. So this is exactly like any other Nexa key. They have made sure that the XL6 gets a different key compared to the Maruti Ertiga. So it's nice, it's small, it's compact, it's easy to use. So that is all on the details. Well, this vehicle also gets automatic headlamps and automatic this is the automatic headlamp control, and this here is the automatic wiper control. So that is also a really good thing. Being a premium vehicle, people are expecting such features to be in a car which costs around 14 lakhs. Yes, exactly, this automatic top end Alpha XL6 model costs around 14 lakhs on road. For that price, the quality may not be as good, but you get the features all you want. You get automatic temperature control, you get cruise control, you get leather wrapped steering wheel, you get leather seats all around. The quality of the leather seats is also really impressive. It's kind of similar to the Maruti Sias, but the thing is, certain quality issues, certain fit and finish issues are present in these leather seats. You can see that the material itself is wavy over here. Apart from that, everything remains totally similar to the Maruti Ertiga. Yeah, and another thing is that you get a different roof lining material, which feels a bit premium than the Maruti Ertiga. The Ertiga gets a usual kind of a rough material roof lining, but this one has a better roof lining material. But it's definitely not the most premium and most best feeling material, but it's okay, it just works. Certain things they have missed is that you get only yellow bulbs for the interior dome lighting. Dome lights are present for all three rows. You can see that there is one for the second and third row combined. And you get one, I mean, you get two at the front. Well, you get dual airbags as standard in terms of safety, along with ABS and automatic transmissions. Get traction control, ESP and other features as well. Rest of the details, you can see that the doors remains exactly the same. You get the exact same sized bottle holders and storage pockets in the door panels. This being an automatic transmission, there are only two pedals, and the dead pedal space is massive. You get whole lot of space. The pedals are of standard Maruti quality. There is no aluminium finish or four metal finish or anything. It's okay. There is this one small pocket holder, like small things you want to store, and you can store it here to the right side of the driver. Well, that is all about the front. Well, you get two vanity mirrors, one for each passenger. Even the driver gets a vanity mirror, which is really surprising, with a light. So okay, so this makes the car really premium. And yeah, that's all. You get height adjustable front seat belts, which is also a really good thing. You get driver seat height adjustment as well as standard. But the thing is, it's manual only, no electric adjustment on any of these variants. And yeah, the steering is also tilt adjustable, but no telescopic, unlike the S-Cross and the Baleno. You get only tilt adjustment on this vehicle, since this being based on the Maruti Ertiga. This here is the Smart Play touchscreen system. The system is exactly same as the Ertiga. So let me just turn it on for now. Okay, you can see that it's exactly the same as the Maruti Ertiga. So there is no big difference. Okay, so the fuel, it can show you all the warnings you want, like fuel level being low or any other things regarding navigation. It can even navigate to your nearest fuel pump. It's okay to use. It's definitely better to use than the previous systems. This is the trend now for Maruti. They are bringing the Smart Play system on every car, even the upcoming new Espresso, the small quid rivaling SUV inspired Espresso. That's what they are decided to call. And even that car is supposed to get the Smart Play system. It's easy to use, it's good to use, it's fine. Well, it is simple to use. It is not the most responsive, but it's simple to use. That's a really good thing. The audio quality though remains really pretty Maruti like. You get 6 speakers, but all those 6 speakers sound really dull. Not the best. Being a premium car, they should at least upgrade these speakers. Given that certain cheaper cars get better speakers now. And this is the instrument cluster. It's exactly the same as on the Maruti Ertiga, except for certain small details which they have taken care of. For example, if you open the door, the instrument cluster shows an XL6 in the MID, which is really good. They could have made some small mistake by carrying over the Ertiga image instead of an XL6, but they took the effort to change the image as an XL6, to make it as an XL6 instead of the Ertiga. Rest apart, you can see that everything remains the same. This is the smart hybrid system. This smart hybrid system is equipped on this 1.5 liter 4 cylinder all new petrol engine, which was introduced on the Maruti Sias, the new Ertiga, as well as on this XL6. And this is also soon to be launched on the S-Cross and the and the Brezza as well. So both of these cars also are expected to get this new 1.5 liter engine. You get a standard size glove box as well, which is really standard. It's just an average size. This is the Smart Play infotainment system manual for this car. Well, that's it on the front. I'll get into the back seat now. Opening the back door, you can see that I have properly adjusted all the rear four seats in their least and the maximum positions. That seat is pushed all the way forward and reclined in the most upright position, and this seat over here is reclined the most backward and pushed all the way back for maximum legroom. The driver seat is adjusted for my height, which is around 5'10 for reference, and even the back seat I have adjusted. You can see that this seat is set all the way forward into its most upright position, and that seat is reclined all the way back. So yeah, I'll just sit over here and judge the space. Well, there is nothing to judge the space because it is already an Ertiga, which has been to the Raymond's showroom and returned back in a premium suit. That's what I feel, because there is exactly the same amount of space, exact same amount of comfort as on the front seats. So yeah, previously the normal Ertiga bench did not have this much kind of thigh support, but this seat really helps the thigh support by dividends. It's really good, but I feel that it's definitely not as comfortable as the front seats, because you can see that the front seats has much more extension into the seat base, but this one is a bit short. I don't know why, but this is definitely not the best captain seats I have been in. That award goes to the Tata Hexa and the Toyota Innova. Well, this here is another look at the dashboard. It indeed is an Ertiga in a premium Raymond suit. So that's what I feel. Well, here also you can see the Ertiga reference. These vents and this control, everything feels exactly the same as on the Maruti Ertiga. And even the seat levers, you can see that the levers over here, these also have been carried from the Maruti Ertiga. So are the rear seats, the third row seats. You get the similar charging socket panel over here, which is a really good thing. Well, rest of all, the view from the inside, it exactly looks like a black Maruti Ertiga interior. So people sitting inside the car won't feel like this is an XL6, and there is nothing exclusive in this except for the captain seats. But that saying, the quality of the leather is really good. I am really comfortable in this seat. There is no heating issue. Well, even though this is in an AC showroom, I feel that this will keep people, business class people, really comfortable. And that is all the way the rear seats can be slid, roughly about 24 centimeters, I guess, because the previous Ertiga had a 24 centimeters of seat sliding adjustment. So yeah, that is all about the back seat. You get the same door panel, nothing exclusive, the same door handles, the exactly same pathetic door window controls, exactly the same bottle holders on the door, exactly same speakers. There is nothing different, nothing changed except for these captain seats. And that is all about the middle row, and that is all about the third row as well, because it has good space, it has good amount of space. If the seat is slid a little bit forward, well, let me just slide my seat a little bit forward so that I have adequate space over here. So that is there. I'll just slip on into the second, sorry, the third row. So getting into the third row through the middle is also possible, which is a really good thing, but I do not recommend that, say, for well-built people, because the gap is indeed really small. The leg room over here is okay, given that I have adjusted the incline to a bit more relaxed position. So I am okay with the leg room. I can sit here for like a couple hours. I have just this bit of leg room over here, and the seat back itself is soft and comfortable to, even if you want to rest your knee on the seat back, it's okay. But this position is a totally no-go. This is a totally upright position. This position is best used only if there is some big luggage in the boot. I recommend you to slide the third row always all the way back. This here is the view from the third row. You can see the theater style position over here. The front seats are low, the second row seats are a bit higher, and the third row seats are even a bit higher. So it gives you a clear view. The cabin is airy even though being all black. Even the third row gets massive mirrors, which are of course carried over from the Maruti Ertiga. So there is nothing new over here. It's a really useful and practical interior. Only thing, the quality is definitely not up to the price. You get this small yellow bulb. Come on, yaar. It's 2019 and they are still giving these yellow bulbs. That's what is really turning off the premium feel of the Nexa cars. So that's all of the interior. Opening the boot, you can see that the boot space is also exactly the same as on the Maruti Ertiga. You get exactly the same split seats. Well, it is the same. It's basically the same car. You get the exact same floor panel, which can be adjusted to two levels. I'll just adjust it over here. That's it. So you can basically extend the boot floor all the way down to increase the boot space. Or you can just make this into a reclined, more upright position. So that is all. And even the boot space also remains the same, except for the fact that you can't actually fold the captain seats for a full flat position to extend the boot space. So I'll just fold these two third row seats. This is the maximum space available. The claim space is around 630 liters against the Maruti Ertiga's maximum space of 850 liters, I guess. I'm not sure, that's an approximate figure. This here is the jack pocket over here. You can access the jack point over here, just like on the Ertiga. And 3-point seat belts for the third row passengers, which is also really good. So, yeah, coming to the second row folding, I'll show you that as well. In order to get into the third row, you have to just pull this lever. Pulling this lever automatically pushes the seat all the way forward, and you can just access it in one touch. So that's a really easy function. But this is the amount of space all you get to access the third row. If you lock the third row seat belts, the second row seat belt over here, it won't hinder in your way. That's it, I have inserted that. This is all the space you get to access the third row, which is okay, better than the previous Ertiga. It is also easier than the previous Ertiga as well to get in, because the vehicle's height and overall length has also been increased. So yeah, that's all about the third row. And accessibility, getting out is a bit little tight though. So okay. Overall, it's a really comfortable and practical six-seater family car. So I'll just go to the yard and show you the manual vehicle as well.
So I am now in the yard of Ambal Auto, and this is the manual petrol vehicle of the XL6. Being a manual vehicle, there is no visual difference between the automatic and the manual, which is really weird, but the difference lies only on the inside.
So this here is the manual vehicle. I'm just getting inside right now. Everything remains exactly the same as the automatic vehicle, but the only difference lies in the middle. This here is the manual vehicle. So it gets a 5-speed manual transmission, but I would seriously like a 6-speed transmission given this vehicle is capable of doing highway duties. But this is fine given the power and torque figures. Everything remains exactly the same. There is no difference between the automatic and the manual. Another thing missing on the manual is that you don't get traction control feature. So that is a kind of a miss. It's kind of a partial thing to the automatic variants. Probably because Maruti Suzuki is cautious that people may drive the automatic. Well, people who don't have any experience with automatic may drive the automatic variant. That's why they are probably giving the traction control and they missed it out on the manual. So that is all the difference between the manual and the automatic variants. On the outside also you can see that it's got no difference at all. Everything remains exactly the same. You get the smart hybrid badging at the back. You get the regular XL6 badging at the back. But I personally think that the blue looks really cool on the XL6. So yeah, that is all about the new XL6. Do let us know what do you think. So let's go back to the yard and let's go back to the showroom. For this review, I would especially like to thank my very beloved friend Mr. Kalidas Nexa, and he can cover the western and south side all over Tamil Nadu. So his number is in the description box below, so you can definitely contact him for any Nexa car. He can provide you the best experience you definitely need. Thank you, Kalidas. That's it. The headlamp throw of the LED setup on the XL6 is seriously good. As you can see, this is the parking lamp, this is the low beam, and that is the high beam. So that is how powerful it is. It literally blinds everything in the opposite and really has got a long throw to it. So it's a really good setup. It's a good reason that Maruti chose to put LED lights on the XL6. So that was all about the all new Maruti Suzuki XL6. I wouldn't say that it's a brand new vehicle. It is basically just a Maruti Ertiga in a premium Raymond suit. But it is really a practical car and really a comfortable car when you want a Maruti Ertiga like affordability in a much more premium business class like category. It competes with the Mahindra Marazzo, the Honda BRV, and the likes. And when compared to that, you get a whole lot of features and equipment to compete with the price. So that is all about the new XL6. Do let us know what do you think about the new Maruti XL6. I think that it's a practical car but a little bit higher on the price category. So thanks for watching. This is Viprajesh signing off. See you on another video.
Watching this video, please subscribe for more videos. If you like this video, click the like buttons and give your comments.